keep going.
Take this. You've earned it.
Wow, I've never seen one of you knife ears dressed like the King of Ferelden before. You made good for yourself, eh? Oh, I don't mean no offense. I know I shoot my mouth off. I'm just not used to your kind, trussed up all fancy.
Oh, there I go again. I don't mean nothing by it. I swear I should start over. I'm mighty pleased to be making your acquaintance, sir. Mocking? No, I was just saying it's nice to meet someone such as yourself. I'm the ferryman. Leastwise, I used to be. Poor old Kester. Out of a job.
Gregor just came down and said, "Don't you worry, Kester. We got it all under control, we do." Didn't say nothing else. And then he puts Carol in charge of my boat, Lissy, named for my grandmum she was. If I had to guess, I'd guess it had to do with magic, but the tower's always got something to do with magic. Do I look like a Templar? A mage? Why would they tell me anything? Well, you go on ahead. Gregor tells me to stay here, I stay here. I reckon the fella knows what he's talking about. Oh, I can't say that. I'm lucky he's good enough to give me the time of day. The first enchanter's all right. He's polite as can be, but he's always a little distant, if you get my drift. But Gregor will stay to talk. I reckon he likes hearing from us common folk, you know? He's a man to be respected, that Gregor. I reckon it's good for them mages. Gather them all, learn them some proper magics. I know what they say about mages, but the Maker made them for a purpose. If you can't trust him, who can you trust? All right, keep safe, you hear?
You! You're not looking to get across to the tower, are you? Because I have strict orders not to let anyone pass. No one gets to the tower. No one. The tower is off limits to all. Oh, you're a Grey Warden, are you? Prove it. So I'm not good enough for you. Fine. See if you get into the tower on your own. Is that bad? Look, I'm, just trying to do my job. I'll take you right now, just like you wanted. Come along, I suppose.
And I want two men stationed within sight of the doors at all times. Do not open the doors without my express consent. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Now we wait and pray. Who are you? I explicitly told Carol not to bring anyone across the lake. We're dealing with a very delicate situation. You must leave for your own safety. I am weary of the Grey Warden's ceaseless need for men to fight the Darkspawn, but it is their right. You'll find no allies here. The Templars can spare no men, and the mages are indisposed. I shall speak plainly. The tower is no longer under our control. Abominations and demons stalk the tower's halls. The circle is lost. The tower has fallen. My men did what they could, but it wasn't enough. They took us by surprise. We were prepared for one or two abominations, not the horde that fell upon us. I will destroy the tower, raze it to the ground. But I cannot risk more of my men. The doors remain shut, and they will protect us for now. We do not mean for the doors to stay closed forever. Everything in the tower must be eliminated. I have sent word to Denerim, calling for reinforcements and the right of annulment. The right of annulment gives Templars the authority to neutralize the Mage Circle. Completely. This situation is dire. There is no alternative. Everything in the tower must be destroyed so it can be made safe again. No one could have survived those monstrous creatures. It is too painful to hope for survivors and find nothing. A while ago, and it worries me, the Civil War has no doubt caused much turmoil. Has the Chantry been caught up in it? I can only guess. Denerim must have received our message. It cannot be much longer. I, too, would like to know how this started. I assure you, an abomination is a force to be reckoned with, and you will face more than one. That is a surprise. Did you manage to put it down? If you have fought an abomination, then you understand their evil. You know what they are. Madness and cruelty made flesh. You think you can deal with them when even Templars are loath to enter the tower? If you succeed, I would owe you much, enough that I would pledge my Templars to your cause. Without word from Denerim, I must determine our course. Surely destroying Darkspawn is a worthy goal. We have nothing to offer you but gratitude and service. I have heard the tower holds many valuable artifacts. I expect we'll have to consider them lost or destroyed. A word of caution. Once you cross that threshold, there is no turning back. The great doors must remain barred. I will open them for no one until I have proof that it is safe. I will only believe it is over if the first enchanter stands before me and tells me it is so. If Irving has fallen, then the circle is lost and must be destroyed. May Andraste lend you her courage, whatever you decide.
My wounds! They burn! It's unbearable!
I wish this were over. We're running low on supplies, and I don't know how much longer we'll last. We need the abominations and demons out of this place, if that's what you mean. If you have anything to trade, that would be helpful too.
Enchantment? Enchantment!
I'm off.
you. No, come no further. Grey Warden or no, I will strike you down where you stand. The tower is a place of learning. Young apprentices are always here. Why is that surprising? But this is no time to discuss that. Why are you here? Why did the Templars let you in? Then you do serve the Templars, as I feared. Do they have the right of annulment? So Gregor thinks the Circle is beyond hope. He probably assumes we are all dead. They abandoned us to our fate. But even trapped as we are, we have survived. If they invoke the right, however, we will not be able to stand against them. Let it suffice to say that we had something of a revolt on our hands, led by a mage named Aldred. When he returned from the battle at Ostagar, he tried to take over the Circle. As you can see, it didn't work out as he had planned. I don't know what became of Aldred, but I am certain all this is his doing. I will not lose the Circle to one man's pride and stupidity. I tried to help the children get out, but the doors were locked. No one responded when I called for help. What else was I supposed to do? I erected a barrier over the door leading to the rest of the tower, so nothing from inside could attack the children. You will not be able to enter the tower as long as the barrier holds, but I will dispel it if you join with me to save the Circle. What? But I told you there are innocent mages still alive who have nothing to do with these demons and abominations. We can search the tower. I will only accept the Circle's loss once I see that no one else lives. No, I know the tower, and I know what we face. And if the Circle is indeed lost, and all the mages dead, I would see this for myself. Lives hang in the balance. There is only one possible course of action, but consider if you must. Well, have you come to a decision? What? But I told you there are innocent mages still alive who have nothing to do with these demons and abominations. If you insist on making war upon the Circle, we have nothing more to discuss. It comes to blows, then. I will stop you, or die trying. Ah! They abandoned us to our... I don't know what became of Aldred. You will not be able to enter the tower as long... What? But I... If you... I will... Come on!
All right. I'm off. Yes.
Right.
Oh, this is rather awkward, what? I'm not supposed to be here. It's not right at all.
Please refrain from going into the stockroom. It is a mess, and I've not been able to get it into a state fit to be seen. I am called Wynne, and I manage the Circle's magical stockroom. I was trying to tidy up, but there was little I could do. The stockroom is my responsibility. I must keep it clean. I tried to leave when things got quiet. That was when I encountered the barrier. Finding no other way out, I returned to work. The stockroom is familiar. I prefer to be here. No, I suppose I should count myself lucky. I would prefer not to die. I would prefer it if the tower returned to the way it was. Perhaps Niall will succeed and save us all. I do not know. But he came here with several others and took the litany of Adrala. The litany protects a mind from blood magic. This is what I have heard. If Niall wanted the litany, it stands to reason that he believes it will be needed. I do not know. I wish you luck. Perhaps this will be over soon and things will return to the way they were. Goodbye.
Please don't kill me. I know I have no right to ask for mercy, but I didn't mean for this death and destruction. We were just trying to free ourselves. Aldred told us that the Circle would support Loghain, and Loghain would help us be free of the Chantry. You don't know what it was like. The Templars were watching. Always watching. The magic was a means to an end. It gave us... It gave me the power to fight for what I believed. We thought someone always has to take the first step, force a change, no matter the cost. And now Aldred's gone mad, and we are scattered, doomed to die at the hands of those who seek to right our wrongs. What else can I do? I'm trapped here. No! No, please!
Yes.
We're going.
Oh, please don't hurt me. Please don't. Please don't hurt me. I'm no one. I'm not important. I just don't want to die. Oh, Maker! Because I'm this close to wedding myself! Thank you. I won't bother you. I'll just be here, all quiet.
Yes. Thank you. I'm off. Right.
I'm off. Yes.
Any more of them around? No? Oh, good.
Ah!
I'm off.
All right.